Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. Back with another look at something I think is made simple in Godot, top-down character movement. First, let's set up our inputs. Open up the project settings under the project option here. Choose the input map tab, and if you're just starting out, this will most likely be empty, but this is not too different from Unity. And what I mean by that is if you've ever used a new input system in Unity, I don't think this will be too confusing. We will create four actions here, but let's start with the first one. Click on this field to add a new action and call it left. Click on the add button to the right or press the return key to save it. You will now see a new action here called left. Click on the plus symbol to the right of it, and in the pop-up you will be able to listen for inputs. Tap on the A key on your keyboard and click on the OK button. Let's add three more actions, right, up and down. And as we did above, listen for the inputs, D for right, W for up, and S for down. If you want to use the arrow keys instead, or add support for arrow keys as well, you can either assign these actions to the corresponding keys, or click on the plus symbol again to listen for the arrow keys. I don't really see how this could have been made more simple. Now, let's quickly create a simple character. I will use the same assets I used in the last video, link in the description. So I'm going to add a new node and search for character body 2D. This will now have a warning symbol, and if you hover over it, you can see that it's missing a shape. So, following the warning instructions, I'm going to add a collision shape 2D as its child. I'm also going to add a sprite 2D node, and drag this character sprite to the texture field in the inspector. The collision shape 2D node here is missing a shape, so after selecting the node, have a look at the inspector to the right and click on empty next to shape up here in the top. You will find a few options here, and which one you should pick depends on the character you are using. For simplicity, I am adding a circle as the shape. More complicated characters would of course require more complicated shapes, but this is out of scope for demonstrating simple character movement. Looking at the folders down in the left corner, I have one called Scenes with a child folder called Player. I just quickly rename the character body 2D node to player and drag it into the player folder. This will save the player node as a scene, and this all looks good, so I'll just click on save. Now, select the player node in the scene tree and attach a new script to it by clicking on this button here, next to the three dots. This script will inherit from character body 2D, I'll just use the default empty template here, and I'll save it as is in the player folder. Click on the Create button and the script will open in the Script tab. You can see your new script together with the player scene here in the Player folder, and that your player node has a script attached to it as indicated by this tiny icon here. First, let's create a variable up here, var direction, which is of type vector2 with a default value of vector2.0. Now, let's start with a process method, which is the equivalent of an update method in Unity. Start by typing func, followed by process. This should autocomplete, so choose the first option here. If you're familiar with delta time in Unity, you'll find the equivalent here, delta. Now, let's type direction equals input with a capital I, dot get vector, and within parentheses type left, right, up, and down, all in quotation marks. These are the input actions we created in the beginning of the video. Now, down here, let's add a physics process, which would be the equivalent to fixed update in Unity. Func, followed by process again, and now choose the physics one. We listen for the input in the regular process method, and apply the direction in the physics process method, so type velocity equals direction multiplied by 50. Velocity here will automatically set the velocity of the node the script is attached to. No need to look for a rigid body or calling the getComponent method. 50 here is the speed value, so we could create a variable up here, var speed equals 50. And of course, we should define the type, so after speed, add a colon and type int to define the speed variable as an integer. To expose this value in the inspector, we need the export keyword, so let's add that here. We should now also change this value here to our speed variable. Now, the only thing that's missing is move and slide right after setting the velocity, and you're done! Simply put, the move and slide method is moving the body based on its velocity. Now, let's finally hit play and see what we have done. See how easy it was to not just start listening for input, but also add a character with a character body 2D and make the character move. And you can set the speed of the movement right here in the inspector. You will probably have two errors down here in the debugger, so click on it and choose the Errors tab. The error tells us that the parameter delta is never used, and that we should prefix it with an underscore, so let's do that right here, for both the process methods. To combine this with my previous video, you could just drag this camera node to the player node to make it a child of it, enable position smoothing in the inspector, and now you have a camera that smoothly follows the player. Again, I'm still a beginner and new to the engine, so see these videos as a way to encourage other Unity developers to at least give other engines a try. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.